Hi, this is John Whiteley, and we're going to take a look at QuickBooks Online. The decision to purchase QuickBooks Online or a desktop version is based on a number of different factors. And later in this video, we'll show a clip from Intuit on navigating inside of QuickBooks Online to see how easy it really is. Now, let's consider the following points. You should have a fast internet connection speed, and you also have to evaluate the need for remote access to your books. Also consider the frequency of your internet downtimes, as this can happen frequently in certain regions of the country. If your internet's down, no access to your accounting system. Also, does your accountant know how to use QuickBooks, or is she or he willing to learn how? Because the online version will make it a lot easier for your accountant to post year-end adjusting journal entries directly on the copy of your data file. Now, Intuit plans to put more money in research and development on the inline version of QuickBooks rather than the desktop version. So one would assume that over time the online version will just get better and better. There are three different levels for the QuickBooks Online. At the lower cost is the simple start, then it moves up to the online essentials, and then the QuickBooks Online Plus. Now, it is strongly recommended that you consult with your CPA before making a final decision. You'll have to review your accounting and reporting requirements to know the best choice. And who better to talk to than your CPA, who should know exactly what the requirements are for your business. Now, a small consulting business, for example, with one owner, may find the simple start version adequate. However, if payables and time control are important, then that person will have to move up to the essentials level. You can compare features at the Intuit website. Now, please note that prices may vary between the USA and Canada. Now, let's watch the following clip from Intuit on how to navigate within QuickBooks Online. And if you need help in consultation setting up your QuickBooks, please contact me, John Whiteley, at my website.
So we're going to click on QuickBooks Online, right? We're going to choose the customer tab and choose Kevin James. And at the top right, we're going to click the plus symbol. We're going to choose Invoice. And let's pretend you're running a consulting firm, so you're going to bill him by the hour. So we're going to choose hours here. You actually spent 2 hours with Kevin James today. And because you're really good at what you do, you charge $200 an hour. And the tax we're choosing is HST, okay? So we're just going to click Save at the top right. Now, the next screen, you see the little arrow symbol. This is where we're going to send the invoice from. You have several options here, but we're going to email it. All this information has been readily populated. This is the preview of the invoice he's going to see. And here we go. We click Send. And that's how easy it is to send an invoice using QuickBooks Online. The second feature I want to discuss with you guys is how easy it is to navigate through QuickBooks Online. The purpose of the design was basically to minimize the learning curve. So let me show you how simple it is to navigate through the interface. Let me show you how easy it is to work through QuickBooks Online. I'm going to point your attention to three main areas that you're going to use to navigate through the program. The first area, as you may notice, here where my mouse is located, is the left side toolbar. This toolbar is going to allow you to access your customers or suppliers, and you can see many options down here, but let's just talk about your customer suppliers for right now. If I were to click on this tab, I would be able to create a new customer and also create an invoice for that customer. In addition to, if I was to click on this tab, the suppliers tab, I'll be able to create a new supplier and a bill or check expense for that supplier. Now let's move over to the top middle navigation toolbar. This toolbar is going to allow you to create forms for either customers, suppliers, or even employees. So let's click on it. So you can see the different columns that are here for customers, suppliers, employees, and others. Well, in the customer column, you can see where you could create invoices, receive payments, and estimates right away. And in the suppliers column, you can see how you could create expenses, checks, or bills immediately. Now, for example, let's say that you wanted to find, the most recent transaction that you actually created. Well, this tab next to that plus icon is a recent transactions tab. And this will pull up the most recent transactions that you've created in QuickBooks Online. Now, what if that transaction isn't actually there? Well, you go down here to the word more and you click on this, and this would actually bring you to all the transactions that you created in QuickBooks Online. And see how you can filter it to all transactions. Now, what if you didn't want to work through that list and kind of scroll through to find a transaction and you actually knew the transaction number you were looking for? Well, you click on the magnifying glass, and let's say that the transaction that we were looking for was 1004. Click on Go. It'll open up transaction invoice of 1004. It's really that simple. So let's close this screen here. The next tab that I want to bring to your attention is the company tab. So if we click on the company tab, this will give you access to your settings. So you see where it says company settings. This is similar to the preferences in QuickBooks Desktop. And if you wanted to create products and services, well, you click on the products and services list, and you're able to create products and services in this screen. Let's go over to the Your Company column here. Now, your account here is where you're going to access all the billing information for your account. And Manage Users is where you're going to create users for QuickBooks Online. And you could take note of the sign out tab as well. Okay. Now, the last thing I want to bring to your attention is the help feature in QuickBooks Online. If you had any challenge whatsoever with QuickBooks Online, creating accounts or creating invoices or setting up your expenses, or you wanted to look at a profit and loss report and you weren't sure how to find it, all you have to do here is type whatever that challenge is, and this will direct you to our online community, which you'll be able to find various articles and different help tools to show you how to find the items that you're looking for in QuickBooks Online. As you can see, QuickBooks Online is fairly simple to use. And I want to bring another thing to your attention before we close here. A good rule of thumb with QuickBooks Online is to follow the red. So as you can see, I have 4 invoices that are overdue, totaling $50. And if I were to go over to the activities feed, you could see those 4 invoices sitting here. And if I were to click on one of the invoices, when it opens up the invoice screen, I can receive the payment from there. With QuickBooks Online, it's that simple.